As I mentioned in the last video, we currently have no information about the user who actually posted on their own photos. At no point in time did we ever actually access the user's table, so we cannot print out their username. So let's try to fix that. We're going to alter this query so that we not only post out the URL of the photo, the contents of the comment, but I also want to get in here the username of the person who actually posted on their own photo. To do this, we're going to have to use a little bit of advanced technique around joins. So let's walk through a diagram really quickly and understand what is going on first, and then we'll start to write out a little bit of SQL. All right, so here's the idea. We are going to do a three-way join. A three-way join is where we merge together three different tables. Now, conceptually, this is definitely very challenging, but the actual SQL for it ends up being very simple and straightforward. But again, conceptually, very hard to understand. So in this case, we need information from comments and photos and users. We have to pull values from each of these. And that means that we need to join them all together into the same temporary table. So down here, I once again have this imaginary fake table, and it has columns from all three different tables. Here's a set of columns right here from comments. We've then got the two or three from photos, and then the two from users right there. So we can first get started by selecting all the different rows inside of comments, and then we'll put them into this imaginary table. We can then join on photos. And as usual, we'll go through and take a look at the photo ID and make sure it matches up with a ID out of the photos table. So we start off first with photo ID 2, throw it down, photo ID 3, and photo ID 1. Okay, so that's how far we've gotten at this point in all the past videos. We've gotten this far, no problem whatsoever. So now we are saying that we want to somehow merge in this third table. Merging in this third table is going to require us to really think about the merge condition, or essentially the comparison that we are putting right here on that on section. If we just put in something like comments.userid equal to users, so in other words, if we just try to match up this column right here to this column right here, that will not necessarily give us users who posted on their own photo. Let's think about what condition we are really trying to check for. What we really want to see is when this user ID right here is equal to that user ID right there and equal to some ID inside of this table. That's what we are really looking for. We want to see where this ID, and some row out of this table are all equal to each other. So in the first case, we have a user ID of 2 right here for the comment, and then a user ID of 3 for the photo. There's going to be no user, or there is no user, who created both the comment and the photo, because these IDs are different. And so we can really imagine that right here for this first row, we would get null and null. Now, when I say we would get, I just mean to say, like, logically, not even worrying about SQL or anything like that, there is no user who satisfies the condition of having an ID equal to this user ID and that user ID. So there's no value we could put inside there because no user can satisfy this condition. But on the next row, we want to try to find a user with an ID equal to that value and that value. Is there one? Well, yeah, here they are right here. So this is a user that satisfies both of those constraints. This user has an ID equal to that value and that value. So now we would say that Frederick Donnelly created the photo of whatever that URL is right there, and they created a comment with that contents on their own photo. Now we can repeat this process for the third row. In this case, we are looking for a user with an ID equal to 3, and a user with an ID equal to 2. Well, once again, there is no user who can satisfy that. There's no user who has an ID of 3 and 2. And so again, we would end up with null values right there. So now at this point in time, if we just printed out this table as is, we would end up with some values in here that say null. And we don't really want those values. We only want to see comments and photos where the user posted the comment and the photo. So we could try to either do some kind of where expression, some kind of where check, where we'd say, yeah, don't show us any usernames or any rows where the username is equal to null. Or alternatively, remember, we just took a look at those four different kinds of joins, And we spoke about how an inner join is only going to show us rows where there is a matching value from all tables involved. So if we did this three-way join with an inner join, then these rows where there's no matching user would essentially fall out, and we are left with just this one row right here. Okay, so that is the theory. That is what we essentially want to implement. So let's now go over to our editor. We're going to make a real small change to the query we've already got inside there. And we're going to see that, well, writing out the SQL for a three-way join is really simple, but again, understanding it is a lot more challenging. Okay, so back over here, we still have select URL and contents, but now we also want to get the username. We're going to take all the rows from comments. We're going to join photos, and we want to find or somehow merge these two tables together by finding where the photos ID is equal to comments.photoID. So that's what got us to kind of like stage one right here, where we just had this first set of columns. And now we want to add in the users table as well. For that, right after the first join, we can add in another join. So on this additional join, we're going to add in users on, and then this part right here, the merge criteria, this is the important part. So we want to somehow merge these users in, and our criteria for this is to find where the user's ID is equal to the comment user ID, and the user ID is equal to the photo user ID. So we would write this out with an and expression. We would write out users.id equal to comments.userid. That's going to make sure that we find a user with an ID equal to the comments user ID, and users.id is equal to the photos.userid. And that should do it. So the entire key here is that we are trying to find users or merge these things all together where the user's ID is equal to the comment ID and the user's ID is equal to the photos user ID at the same time. That's going to make sure that all three of these different values, user's ID, comments user ID, and photos user ID, are equal to each other. Okay, so let's now run this, and it looks like it worked. Now, in theory, these are all photos and comments where the author of the photo and the comment is that person right there. If you want to, you could do a select star from comments, select star from photos, and select star from users, and compare the IDs of each of these different records and just make sure that they actually do match up to each other. But I'll leave that up to you. All right, so this has been a rather advanced use of a join statement. It is a three-way join because we are joining together three different tables. And the key thing to keep in mind here is that whenever we do a three-way join, usually that second join, this one right here, is going to have a little bit more complicated merging expression because we need to really think about, well, what values or what rows go with whichever rows. Okay, so let's take a quick pause right here and continue in just a moment.